over here for another amazing Pendulum video. I was sitting in my lab the other day, trying to think of new ideas to keep the channel spicy. So I did what all geniuses do. Called upon my magic potion, but it finally hit me.
What the fuck, dude?
And I got the greatest idea of all time.
Endymion.
Endymion, baby. We are doing a whole new series called Archetype Analysis. We're gonna make sure that when this deck comes out, you guys, the greatest fans in the world, destroy your opponent with it. So, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. I don't want to go hurt my lion like I did the last video. Hit that subscribe button. Get your boys to hit that subscribe button. Share it on Facebook, and let's go. Unfortunately, there won't be any interviews for this series. I know you guys like the interviews I've been doing, but unfortunately, Kazuki Makakuchi is busy with Akuchi, and unfortunately, Nurturf is busy on a date with his right hand. So none of them are available for today. So unfortunately, we're gonna have to ride solo for this one. So there I was, all alone. No friends. No one wants to help the pen god, bro. No one wants to help with the pen god, and you know, it's all good. Cause I walk alone. Hey, Trev. Yeah, party Trev, what's up, man?
I heard you needed some help, brother.
What do you know about Yu-Gi-Oh, though, man? You're always drunk and partying. Honestly, fine, man. I don't got anyone else. Fine, come. I'll interview you today, bro. I'll interview you today. Let's go. At least you don't have one of those stupid damn theme songs. Thank God. As long as you don't have one of those. You're indoors. Can you at least take off the sunglasses? Alright, let's just get straight into the video.
Hey bro, before we start, can you get me a water, man?
Oh sure, bro, I'll give you a water.
Thanks, bro.
What was the point of the water?
Just for later, bro. You never know.
Alright, so bro, tell my friends, what is the game plan behind Endymion? What is the game plan behind the whole deck?
There's a game plan behind every deck. Now, I'm not going to sit here and be like, intro, they play spell counters, and you need spell counters, and they're all pendulum cards. Everyone already knows that shit, alright? So I'm going to sit there and say, there's 4,000 characters in all the effects. Everyone knows all that already, right? I'll explain what the cards do. I'll explain how to win with it. I'll explain the game behind it. We're not going to sit here and act all cute thinking you guys know, thinking you guys don't know it's about spell counters and talk about little intro shit like that. All right, this ain't that type of channel. This is a channel for winners, all right? If you don't know Endymions, use spell counters, go to another rookie channel like Farfa, all right? Anyways, actually, he doesn't even talk about Yu-Gi-Oh! He talks about feet picks and stuff. Who does that? Who likes feet picks? Anyways, send feet picks. As I was saying, the game plan is simple. You want to get as many possible spell counter cards, any card that could store spell counters, any cards that could activate spell counters, any cards that could put spell counters on different cards, and play the most purest, consistent turbo list as possible. 40 cards, unfortunately, for this one, and make it as pure as possible. Now, you could be cute and stuff and throw in, like, an Odd Eyes engine, a Zephyr engine, because they already have field spells, even a Pendulum Magician engine, but that is not the best version of Endymion. The best version of Endymion is the purest version possible. That's the game plan. You want to play as many spell counter cards as possible to trigger all their effects. They're similar. Draco cards, true Draco cards. They have all their cards have like three different effects, right? Very similarly do Endymions. They all have many, many effects that need spell counters in the field. So even though Metal Draco was a thing before, the best version of true Draco was always pure. Just as the best version of Endymion will always be pure Endymion. You need to play as many cards possible, add all the spell counters on it. Now, the end board here, it is very similar to my classic 5 negate board, alright? But instead of 5, put a 4. But the beauty of it is it does not need its extra deck at all. You can literally play Pot of Extravagance if you want to. You're not going to because you can't risk to banish the best card in the world, Electrum. But what we are going to do is play some spell cards. Now, I will show you guys my list at the very end, but you need to understand the game plan behind everything first. So first and foremost, you want the end board to be double Jackal, double Big Boss, and Endymion, which I'll explain them all later. So since you want two Jocko at the end board and two Endymion on the end board, and we're going to talk about it all at the very end on how every single card works and all that, so stay tuned and don't miss it. But you want the whole deck to ensure every turn you can bring out two Boss Endymion and two Jocko Kings. In order to do that, you have to play different cards to ensure you do that. So I'm going to now go through every card that you should be playing in the deck and every card you should be picking up. That is the intro to Endymion. Now I'm going to get into more so the cards you need to play, the cards you need to pick up, and be ready for.
Alright, I agree with that game plan. Alright, next. Tell me every single card in the archetype. Tell me every card you gotta play. Tell me every card that's good in the deck. Every card that you might play. Tell me all about the cards in it. What card you should play. Tell me all about that stuff, bro.
First and foremost, we're gonna talk about the boss of the deck. Endymion, blah, 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 blah. Big name, but it's the Boss Endymion. That's how we're going to refer to it from now on. What the Boss Endymion does is part of the end board. It, when it's on the field, you could put back to your hand a card that has a spell counter on it and negate any spell or trap. This is vital. This is vital because it now gives you another pendulum that's a negate. Jackal negates monster effects. This negates spell and trap effects. Match made in heaven. You want two of each on board, and you won the duel. The beauty of it is that every turn could do it. Well, something else I love about this deck before we get into it more is that hand traps don't stop it. Hand traps don't stop it at all because you always put up a Jackal before the Electrum comes out. So we're going to talk about more later. It's why you really got to focus on Jackal for this one. But the monster effect is, like I said, its scale effect is also really, really good. But its scale effect can only be used going second. So going second, when your opponent... when it has six counters, you can remove six counters from your field, six spell counters, which is why you must play every card in the game that could play spell counters. We're going to talk about more in the future. We're even playing the Endymion Lab. We're playing Citadel, a field spell, Terraformings, anything you can. Every pendulum card that could store them. It's an amazing pendulum Endymion deck. It's absolutely amazing. Now, what it does going second, this card is remove six counters from your field, special summon, and destroy up to two cards, essentially, from your opponent's field, essentially. This card's amazing. The second effect seems really good, but it's tough. Or the scale effect seems really good, but it's actually really tough to summon it like that. The most ways you're going to summon is by Pendulum Summon, by Servant of Endymion, by Magister of Endymion, Empress of Endymion, which I'll explain them all later. But you always find ways to send it to your extra deck or special summon it from your deck, and it's a spell trap negate, and you really want to really turbo this card out. You want two of them first turn and two Jackals first turn. It's the boss of the deck, negates spells and traps. Next, Servant of Endymion. This one isn't the boss of the deck, but it is the best card of the deck. What it does is simple. What this card does is it brings out any monster from your deck. Any monster from your deck that can place a spell counter on. So any pendulum you can place a spell counter on. You remove three spell counters from itself when it's on the scale to special summon itself and a Jackal King, a Cerberus, an Abductor, a Boss Endymion, whatever you want from your deck, special summons it. So this is a one-card Electrum in itself. All it needs is spell counters. That's it. Which is why, like I said, you gotta play all the spells possible. And not stuff like Zephyr. I know it's cool you can like search a card, search another. I know it's cool and all that. But cards that can store spell counters are also more important. Absolutely amazing card. His monster effect is not as good. You can discard a card. Got a spell counter, everything you need on the field. You don't really need that because you always have the cards that store spell counters. But it's the main card of the deck, and also the main card you search with the searcher spell. This one, in my opinion, is the next best monster of the Endymion engine, and that is Magister Endymion. This card's also really good. Now, it's not more so looked at as a turbo card like the Servant is. Servant and the spell card that searches Servant, you could play it in any Pendulum deck. But in terms of the pure version here, Magister's the next best because what it does is when it's on the field, it equals another monster negate. So what it does is when it's on the, it's kind of the exact same effect as Empress, except it, not the scale effect. So the scale effect is of Empress is the monster effect of Magister. So what Magister does is when it's on the field, remove three counters from your side of the field, which is why you gotta play the field spells, the continuous spells, everything that can store counters. Remove three from your field, not from itself, just from anywhere from your field, which is amazing, and summon any single monster you can store spell counters on from your deck. So that's what you bring in the big boss Endymion. It's absolutely amazing, that card. I absolutely love that card. A combination of both Servant and Magister ensure that you are always going to have two Boston Demon and two Jackals on board all the time. And two Spell Trap Nick and two Monster Knight when they're Pendulums. Because you don't use your extra deck. You don't XYZ. They don't go to the grave. They go to the extra deck. So you just pencil some in the back and just win. So it's really, really good. Another card, another Endymion card. This one is the worst out of all of them, in my opinion, is Empress of Endymion. What this does, before we get into it, Magister's scale effect. I didn't talk about that one. You could remove three counters from it on the scale. To special summon a any monster from your extra deck, you can play scale spell counters on. Now, you are rarely going to activate that one, to be honest. You kind of do it after your pen summon. You summon itself as well as one of them, but it is really not that needed. You typically do it after your pen summon, so you make sure you keep it on board after your pen summon, and you link a little bit, add another decode or something, if you want another interruption, and then you bring on Magister with another card from your extra deck, and it kind of just ends up with it kind of equals another monster to get in itself because it brings out Endymion, right? So it's good. Empress, though, what it does is, in the scale effect, remove three counters from it. Oh, they all have that effect. The Empress, the Magister, and the Emperor, Servant, Magister, Empress all have that effect where you remove three counters from itself on the scale. To special summon, Servant does from deck, Magister from extra deck, and Empress from hand. Now, the fact that it's from hand is bad because you're going to pendulum summon it anyways. So you're going to use it anyways. So Empress is definitely the worst out of all of them. It's a monster effect, decent going second, but it's not good whatsoever, to be honest. This is the only Endymion card you play one of. Everything else you max out at three. I tried playing three of this, but it's just not that good. You play one of it. Next, the Searcher card. This one searches, it's amazing. It searches any Endymion card you want, and then places an extra spell counter in any card that you could play spell counters on. So it in itself adds one spell counter to every card, and then its effect adds one. So it's like two spell counters in every card, plus searches the servant or the boss and demon that you need. Actually an amazing card. Next, the field spell. The field spell, it's a really good card, man, because it stores field spells and the main, stores spell counters. And the main part about it is you could use spell counters from itself to activate any Endymion effect, which is broken. It is so good. You need to see this card, which is why you play five of it, and you play my pencil right here, and you play so many cards that add spell counters on cards. So having a spell counter store, like storage like that, or the Endymion lab is absolutely vital. You need to open one of the eight or else you can't play, to be honest. It's really tough to play, but since you play a 36 card deck, you have eight ways to do it. You're always going to get it, right? Electrum draw as well. You're going to draw into it. You draw a lot. Like, it's absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing card. Activate all your stuff, and it's never going to die unless you get this, like, Cosmic Cyclone or something, or Unicorn. But honestly, if they take care of that, it's not that big of an issue. You just really need one and just to have a storage anyways. And you're going to always take from it. Absolutely amazing card. You need Terraforming for it as well. Another card is the Endymion Lab Continuous Spell. The main reason you play it, just store spell counters. That's the main reason you play it. And another cool part about it is because you're going a bunch of Pendulum Monsters, you know, whenever a monster you control gets to storm a battle, a Pendulum Monster, you can special summon any Endymion from your deck by removing six spell counters from your field. So that's amazing because it kind of ensures they have to take care of it. They have to take care of it. And if they're going to take care of a spell card that's like not that big an issue, it doesn't matter because you're going to plus from it anyways. You're going to steal spell counters from it. You're not going to want to steal spell counters from your field or from your scale effects. You'd rather steal the counters from Endymion Lab or from the Citadel. So absolutely amazing card. Not many people are going to play it because it seems, it's like a neg one. But the way the deck is, you need to play as many as possible. Next, the Mythical Beast spell. This card is busted in this deck. Mythical Institution, so good, so good. Whenever a Mythical Beast gets destroyed from here, add two counters to it. It's rarely going to get destroyed. More so, you take spell counters from the Endymion Lab, from your Pendulum Scales, from your Mythical Beast that are on the field, from field spell, you take from that and search any card you want in your deck. What it says is remove spell counters from your field, add any monster from your deck, any pendulum monster from your deck that you can put scales on that is up to the level, right? So you can add your Magical Abductor, you can add your level one Jackal, which is huge, which I'm going to talk about next, actually. Next, the Mythical Beast Engine. These cards are so important for this deck. Mythical Beast Jackal. Now, no one plays this one yet. But the second Endymion's come out, this card's broken. Because, for one, it's a level 1 that you can search out with Institution. Next, it's a card you always search with Abductor, to be honest.
And when it's on the field, it brings out, when the three counties, remove three counties from anywhere in your field, when it's on the field, bring out King Jackal. And King Jackal is a big part of the game plan here. You need to see two Jackal and two Endymion, Big Boss Endymion, in your opening hand no matter what. Sorry, in your opening board no matter what. And this card allows you to do it. So the baby Jackal is absolutely vital. You need to play three of this, three Cerberus, three Jackal King. It's just part of the game plan. You need as many ways to Jackal as possible. I can't stress that enough. I cannot stress that enough. The OCG does this. Everyone has to do it. Some people are not. I'd be like, oh, no. What if someone ashes my Cerberus? Big fucking deal, bro. Like, it doesn't matter. Like, it does not matter. Hand traps really don't hurt this deck at all. Simply because you put up a Jackal before the Electrum comes up. Electrum's going to pop it. You're going to have an Endymion before to stop in permanence. Hand traps simply don't stop it. What are you ashing? A Cerberus? You're simply going to pop it. And at the end of the day, a low scale in this deck is a scale 4. Because the only seven cards you want to pen summon really is just Jackal King and the big boss at Nemo, just level seven. So all the mythical beasts equal low scales in this deck, which is why the synergy is amazing. Next, I want to play Magical Abductor as well. This card also absolutely remarkable. If you hard draw Abductor, you're going to activate its effect twice or three times in the turn. It's monster effect. Magister is going to bring it out again. Servant's going to bring it out again. He's going to keep plussing off Abductor, which is why you also have to play a Droll or a Veiler, because you're going to be able to easily, jokingly, search a Droll or a Veiler, and Droll cucks this deck. It's only hand trap that does cuck this deck, and you can search it so damn easily as long as you open Institution or Abductor. So playing if you have Abductor in your deck, it's like you play six Magic Abductors, because the spell card searches it in this deck. Next, I want to talk about is draw cards. So Upstart Goblin, huge in this deck. Absolutely amazing in this deck. Pot of Desire is absolutely amazing in this deck, as long as you don't banish three of your six negates. So your six negates in the deck are three Big Endymion, three Jackal King. Obviously, you can go into your extra deck, but the levels don't really work out for it. So out of those six, if you could banish only two of those six and keep four in your deck, you're good, because you're only resolving one Desires, and then the other Desires, if you open doubles, doesn't matter. Activate, it's just so damn good. You must play three of it, I believe, and you just Nightmare Phoenix it away, Nightmare Cerberus it away, because going second, you really utilize the link cards. You don't ever want to XYZ. You just utilize all the nightmare cards to pop or discard everything. You have so many free cards and advantage that you could freely discard whatever you want. So three Desires is broken in this deck. You can even play Extravagance over the Desires or Upstart if you want. So something I was testing here is playing a DD engine as well, and playing Allure of Darknesses, because all DD cards get you Allure. Playing Sacred Sword of Seven Stars, because there's an Endymion level 7s, an Empress, everything. You can get rid of them, draw two, get more counters and everything. The DD engine could get you the Leonidas to banish. Odd Eyes could do it. Odd Eyes could also get you the Allure target and the Sacred Sword of Seven Stars target to banish.
All right, I like that. Any conclusion on the deck, bro? What's your conclusion? What do you want to tell a lasting thing for the fans?
All in all, this deck is tier 1. I don't care what anyone says. This deck is tier 1 without a doubt the second it comes out. And the balance will only help it. And Konami will only push this deck and only continue to release better cards for Pendulum to only make the deck even stronger than it already is. When the new Link 4 comes out, this deck's going to go insane, because you can summon an Electrum, two Jackal, Boss or two Endymion Jackal, two Endymion Jackal, Electrum, and two random monsters. Electrum and two random monsters going to the new Link 4, which equals three negates like that. And just like that, you got like six negates with three Link Souls going down. It's absolutely broken. This deck's honestly something else. This deck's amazing. So test it out for yourselves on Dueling Book. Wreck all your friends. And we're going to do another archetype analysis on Endymion when it's legal. So this deck's amazing, man. Sick, bro. I love it. Any last remarks for the fans? Can we party now or what? Trip. If you ask me again, I'm going to kill you. Not cool, bro. Not cool.